I've been developing this X-ray app for quite okay. I've always been curious if those X-ray glasses actually worked. I'm sure we would have heard something, but you know, what did they do? Today we're going to be looking at how to create an X-ray effect, and this was highly requested by you guys. So if there is something that you want to see in future, let us know in the comment section down below. Like this video and subscribe. It really helps out the channel and encourages us to do more of these. We're primarily going to be focusing on the second shot of the opening sketch. This effect did include the 3D renderer add-on, but you can still follow along, learn a couple of tricks, and if you like it, then download it for yourself. All right, that's enough of me jabbering. Let's figure this out. First off, for your footage to work, you need your footage to be captured with a certain amount of contrast. In the opening shot, we have three different tones. We have my dark hoodie, the white background, and then me. Ideally, you need your background to be brighter than your subject. The three different tones will give our scanner effect something to work with. So as we look at the original comp, we have a couple of duplications of our footage. We have a model that I've just mentioned, a light, a couple of grade layers. I think that's manageable. I have a new comp open with my footage in place. There's my lovely little face looking into the camera. Let's do some stuff to it. Because we're eventually going to be adding a skull onto me, we need it to stick. So let's first track this footage. It's good practice to check out where the best tracking data is likely to be. I would usually go for my eyes, but because they're quite shadowed, I think my ears might be better. They're also bigger. So select the footage, go to tracks, and then hit the plus icon. I need the type to be double points, as we're gonna go for two of them. And then, ooh, stretchy. Bring that in, go around my ear, yeah. You may have a different area or your eyes may work. Even the nose actually could work pretty well. But like I said, my ears are bigger. They're also well lit. That helps a lot. So I'm gonna track this forward. Now that my tracking is done, we need a point for this to be stuck to. Go to new layer, down to point, reselect the tracker, keep purposes to transform, select the new point that we've got, and rotation and scale. Hit apply. I'm also gonna give this point a rename to tracking point. If we go back into our viewer, we've got a small little point that is stuck to my ear. Before we composite any bones, let's actually make the scanning effect. Okay, so I'm gonna create a new gray layer and rename this scanner. First off, we're going to use a invert. This is going to do a majority of the work for us. Boom. Look at that. This is the foundation of the whole effect. Next up, to give it a bit more of that bluey X-ray sort of feel, you can go for green if you really want to, but I'm gonna go for blue. I'm gonna use a tint and bring my colors to a bluey sort of tone. Gonna bring that to a dark blue, yeah. And then this is a matter of creative preference. Let's see what green looks like. Ooh, yeah, X-ray. That's pretty good, actually. For consistency with my opening sketch, let's go for a blue. Let's add ourselves a curves. Bring that in, I'm gonna close that down, and let's turn that into a J. Yeah. We need the subject to be as dark as possible for the bones to then stand out. Last thing is glow. I'm just gonna bring that intensity down a little bit because it's a little bit too strong for me. We've got the invert effect pretty much there. The only thing that we now need to add is some scan lines. So there are two ways that you can go about this. First off, either way, we need to add a new grade layer and we're gonna call this scan lines. The first method is by using a fractal noise. Bring that in, drop that on. Doesn't look like much right now, but if you go into transform, the axis scale, and then dial up the y-axis. Now all you need to do is just change the blend mode to something that's suitable. I mean, like a soft light, that works really nicely. If you want to add some movement and variation, then you can just go into position and then keyframe the scan lines to move. But there's a much easier way if you have the grunge add-on pack, as it contains scan lines, which is perfect for what we need. And all we're gonna do from here is change the frequency to 500 and the angle to 90. Really want to, you can change the sharpness so it's stronger or a little bit more subtle. Now all we need to do is add some bones and detail onto our subject.
Get to show off my cheekbones.
As I mentioned at the start of this video, this did include the 3D renderer add-on. This choice was because of the motion and detail I wanted to show. As an alternative, you can do a similar thing with an image, but with flat footage, as seen in our first shot of our opener. All I've done with this shot is brought in a photo of this hand x-ray, matched it up with the position of my actual hand, and then tweaked it a little bit. While I'm here, I'll show you what I've actually done with the x-ray app. All I had here was a green screen on my phone and then keyed out the green to reveal my hand. But as I wanted to show more detail and motion, we're going with a 3D model. This model came from Sketchfab and is available down in the description. Now, as I'm mainly using the features and highlights of this model, I'm not going to change any of the material. I'm just going to import as is and hit OK. Bring that skeleton in over your footage layer, and I'm just going to turn off my other layers for the time being, just so we can see what we're up to. So with the model in and it needing to match up with our tracking point, we're going to need to alter the anchor position. So we're going to go into controls, down to anchor position, and then I'm just gonna bring that Y down. Although, because I matched my ears, I am gonna offset it to one of my ears. By having your anchor points in similar positions, it'll help the track immensely. Now it's just a case of scaling and positioning the model. Here I go in a little montage. The best around, no one's gonna get you down. My skeleton is now in position, so I'm going to go to the parent tab and just hit tracking point. It's offset it a little bit, so that's okay. I'm just gonna rotate it back in. You probably noticed that it is just a gray outline on my face right now. So to bring that detail back, go to new layer and bring in a light. Make sure to bring that above your skeleton layer. Again, this is just a personal preference thing, but you can move it around, light it to where you need it to be. Yeah. To bring even more shadows in, go to your skeleton model and click Receive Ambient Occlusion and Casts Ambient Occlusion. This will give us a little bit more detail to play with. So far, my wonderful cheekbones are tracked onto my face and looking great. Let's add a couple of effects to make this blend in with our actual invert. First up, I'm going to add a light wrap to this model. So first off, we want our source layer to be our footage. And then all I'm gonna do is dial up that radius so it covers the entire thing. And maybe set it to add. Who knows? Or screen. Let's go for screen. Kirsty's just popped in.
I need a hat.
Now that we've got that blended on, let's add a diffuse because x-rays don't seem like they're too sharp. And then a small blur. Did I say that funny? And I'm gonna dial that down to about 1, just so it's really subtle. The last thing that we're gonna do is change the blend mode. So before I do, let's turn all the things back on. That looks quite terrifying. This may alter depending on your scene and the lighting setup that you currently have. But for me, I'm gonna try out a couple of things and till I get something that I kind of want. For me, soft light looks pretty good. It's very terrifying, but it's very cool. X-rays are kind of terrifying. One thing that we currently have going on that shouldn't really be there is the amount of detail that is still on me. Cancel this out. Let's duplicate our footage and then grab what is turning into one of my favorite effects, fine edges. Looks a bit weird, but bear with me. Go to the blend mode type and switch this down to multiply. Now I know what you're thinking, it's a little bit strong. So turn down the opacity until you get something that's a nice little blend. Give us a little bit more of a distinction between our skull and our subject. Now that is one spooky, scary skeleton. For the actual reveal of the skeleton, we're gonna be animating the light source so it kind of like moves over the skeleton. We're gonna grab our light, and as this is the end position I want it to be in, I'm gonna go into transform and just add a keyframe here. Go to the start, probably where my tracking point kind of ends. And then now we're gonna move this in Z space back. And you can see already all those shadows gone. That's the type of thing that we want. So as it goes over time, they grow and then eventually form. And that in a nutshell is how it's revealed. All you need to do from here is just play around with the keyframes and maybe add a different interpolation. That's nice. All we're gonna need for the other layers is an opacity keyframe. So I'm gonna start off with this one at the bottom and just go into transform, opacity, start around here and then bring that down, go for the skeleton. And then again, so bring that forward. You can press U to then reveal all the keyframes so we get everything matched up. And our skeleton, I'm gonna bring that down to 0. And now what I can do from this point is right click, go to copy, press U to get out of all the keyframe layers, select our scanner grades, and then paste attributes and just turn off everything but opacity. After a little bit of playtime with the keyframes, you get something like. One last thing to draw focus is a vignette. This is a really easy thing to do. Go to new layer, hit the plane, make sure it's black, call it Vinny. Then go up to the mask tools, elliptical mask, double tap that, invert the mask. We're just gonna feather it a little bit. Don't need to go to a doctor to get an x-ray now. Once again, this tutorial was requested by you guys. So if there is something that you want to see, let us know in the comments section. And as always, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and we will see you next time.